What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to give you the most common expenses that you are going to have when starting your lawn care business. I'm also going to give you some tips and tricks on how to reduce those costs so you'll have more money in your pocket at the end of your first year in business. Let's do it. All right, guys, there are a rabbit hole of expenses that we can go down, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you the expenses that I think provide a good balance between being productive and comfortable without completely overbuying. My disclaimer is I am not going to tell you to go get a push mower from a yard sale, use a curved shaft weed eater from your grandpa's attic, and then use a push broom to sweep up your grass clippings. We're not going to go down that route here. Talking about legitimate options to have a sustainable business. Let's jump into it. The first expense most people will have is in lawn mowing equipment, okay? I'm going to give you a best value option and then also a budget option. A no bells and whistles commercial grade zero turn mower is going to be about $5,000, and a good balance for your other equipment would be two weed eaters, a stick edger, a backpack blower, and then a backup handheld blower, okay? The stick equipment combined with the commercial grade no frills mower is going to cost you about $6,200. The reason that I would recommend going this route is that it provides commercial grade equipment while also giving you some backup equipment, okay? You want to be comfortable and productive whenever you are out working, and I really think this is a realistic cost of what you should expect to get into some decent commercial grade equipment. Okay, the budget option is going to be to get a used residential grade zero turn mower. Just get one weed eater and then a handheld blower. I still recommend you get a stick edger just for liability, okay? It reduces liability so much. Stick with a stick edger, okay? So if you get a used residential grade mower from a homeowner who is moving or something, you can get that for about $1,500 to $2,000. If you decide to go with the budget route, you can expect to spend between $2,500 and $3,000 to get you some quality residential grade equipment. The next major expense that most people will have is the truck and trailer, okay? If you get a no-frills work truck, a pickup truck, and then a utility trailer, I recommend a 6x12. You should budget around $15,000 for both of those items. Again, you can find a good, reliable pickup truck for around $12,000. And then I would recommend probably another $2,000 for a 6x12 open utility trailer. And then add taxes on top of that, you're really going to be pretty close to $15,000 if you take this option. The reason that I recommend the open utility trailer is that it allows you to do so much in your lawn care business when you get started. It's very, very flexible. I know there's benefits to enclosed and that type of thing, but look, I really recommend going this route just for the versatility. Okay, the budget option for your truck and trailer is that you can go on Craigslist and find a beater, you know, just one that you have a mechanic look at and it works well, but it might look awful. But look, you can get a paint job done on that thing for less than $1,000. You can take it to Mako Paint and Body, tell them to give you a budget paint job. They'll just slap on some color. And look, you know, you can get a vehicle for about $4,000 or $5,000. I'm still going to stick with a 6x12 open utility trailer. You could get a smaller utility trailer, but it's only saving you a few hundred dollars, and I promise you will want to have a much bigger utility trailer at some point, and I've just found that a 6x12 seems to be a good fit. So let's stick with the open utility trailer at a 6x12, just like the other option. You get a beater truck with a new paint job. You could expect to spend about $5,000 on this option. Okay, so now you have a truck, a trailer, you have your lawn mowing equipment, you have your stick equipment, and you're ready to go. Now what? Well, the next big expense you're going to have is marketing. Many people will just gloss over this, and it is a huge mistake, guys. Setting a bona fide marketing budget is absolute necessity for the success of your lawn care business. Best value is this. Invest in somebody that will create you a quality website that ranks well in search engine optimization, okay? Secondly, set up an every door direct mail marketing campaign to your area, and that is really going to give you the maximum bang for your buck. The total cost to have somebody build you a quality website and then distribute some postcards through every door direct mail, I would recommend probably spending about $3,000 on that. Okay, a budget option for marketing would be to build your own website if you are good at that type of thing, okay? It's very important that you understand search engine optimization, but if you're willing to put in some work and learn that stuff, you can create a website for fairly cheap, okay? You can distribute your own postcards through neighborhoods yourself, you can knock on doors, and you can use Facebook and other social media to market your business. I will tell you, when I first started, this is the route that I chose. I actually built our initial website. My family got out and distributed postcards. My wife pulled my kids in a wagon, and we literally went around and distributed postcards every spring, several times a month, up until the peak mowing season. The total cost that I had invested in those marketing efforts, not counting my time, but just the actual dollar amount, was about $500 in postcards and the website that I had. I know that does not sound like a lot, but it really was effective, okay? So this can be done, it just requires legwork on your end. So I would say you can do a budget marketing campaign your first year in business for about $500 if you're willing to put in the legwork. Okay, the fourth expense that you're going to have when starting your lawn care business is right there in the title, lawn care business, okay? If I would recommend the best value would be to set up an LLC originally, and then also get $1 million insurance policy for your business, a general liability policy, okay? The cost of setting up your business with an LLC and having $1 million liability policy will be about $1,250. Okay, the budget approach for this, unfortunately, being a legitimate business is the only way that I'm going to tell you how to do things on this channel, and you have to get an employer identification number, you have to go to your county, you have to get licensed to your county, and you have to set up some type of insurance for your business. So again, I'm going to stick with $1,250 even if you're trying to start your business on a shoestring budget. I have found that a total investment into your lawn business for your first year, if you are trying to get a lot of value but still trying to reduce your costs, you can get this done for about $25,000. However, if you decide to go the budget route, you can get it done for just under $10,000, okay? There's no bells and whistles, you're doing a lot of legwork on your own, but you're gonna have about $10,000 invested in getting your lawn care business going. Again, guys, I just want to remind you, I'm not talking about just using crap you have laying around. I'm talking about starting a legitimate business. These are legitimate and realistic expenses that you should expect to have when starting your business. Guys, if you want help in starting your lawn care business, check out any of these videos. They're going to be a tremendous help to get you going in 2020. Y'all take care.